You don't want to leave those options open to them.
Yeah. And we'll see. So, Morgana removed. Right off the bat, still banned away from Mythni. That was, of course, paid, I think, almost every single game by him in the semifinals. And Cloud9 Eclipse say, you know, we're worried about this one. We're worried about the disengage from NIP. Let him get into fights a little bit more. Lee Sin still removed from Ko. So, still afraid of early game aggression from C9E. Of course, Elise was still went through champ select unpicked in the first game. I mean, you think about other early game junglers. So, it's a lot of options still up in the air.
Yeah. And another thing is, a lot of the LCS teams are complaining about this. On Provo side, we always have to swap because of the there's no vision early, and you have to do an invade with your jungler to secure him buff. Are we going to see Ninjas in Pajamas actually do a lane swap? Because everyone's been saying they don't like you know, the 2v1 situation. They like standard laning phase.
Yeah.
So I don't think they will go for that. Cloud9 Eclipse can try and take an advantage. The reason that people always do that lane swap to secure buffs is because the jungler, it makes it so risky for you to not know if the other team is invading your red.
Yeah.
Cloud9, they can go invade Ninjas in Pajamas red side if they know that they won't do a lane swap.
That's true, actually. And I'm actually curious to see what happens because I'm just sort of thinking in theory with NIP, like they have probably one of the most dominant duo lanes in Europe. Like Freeze and Mythi win their lane almost every single time. And if you put them in a 2-on-1, it like partially wastes that advantage, even if it's strategically the right move. And it's always interesting to see, like, will they make the one where they're going to win dual lane for free, or will they make the one where it's strategically more sound?
Yeah, even when they get ganked, they keep on getting kills.
Yeah.
So they probably want to keep those guys matched up in a standard 2v2.
So Febben going to be getting Nidalee for himself that was banned away in the first game, but Lucian still for Freeze, and Leona grabbed away, so Mythi's going to get that champion. Ko now hovering over on the Evelyn.
Interesting. And Morgana's banned out, so won't have that in the duo lane versus the Leona. I still like it, even though a lot of people are like, oh yeah, you can just switch targets with Leona, stun the other one. If you spread out and don't stand next to your AD carry, then it's still going to work.
You just dark binding her when she goes in.
Yeah.
It's like, switch targets now, punk.
So we'll probably see another Thresh, because both these guys, if it's not Leona, then it's Thresh.
Yeah, oftentimes. But they got 25 seconds to make their choice. Evelynn, I keep getting those names wrong. Evelynn, not a very good Riggles jungler. I feel like you really need the mana sustain.
Yeah.
So for what it's worth, if that Eve does come through, a different look here.
Standard build is still really strong. As
yes,
I keep saying, like Kha'Zix and Elise and Evelynn, they all still are just as strong as they were before. There's a 10% nerf on the Lizard Elder jungle item, the Spirit, but it's minimal.
Yeah, it is.
It still has completely the exact same effect, and Evelynn will still go by that. She has great early game damage and great late game tankiness. So it provides a lot of threat all over the map. You have global threat, basically, because they have to respect the Evelynn. They don't know where she is, and all the lanes have to play a little bit safer when they do not have any intel on her position.
Well, she's going to be picked up there, the stealthy jungler here. Karma as well, picked up by C9E, which actually, for the first time, gives NIP pause with their picks. Normally, they come in so quickly, and they know what's going to be coming in, but with Karma, they take some time and say, okay, so Karma plus something versus Lucian, Leona in the bottom lane.
Elise Karma
hover right now.
Adds so much level 1 poke to your team. The early lanes from the Karma lanes, I feel like determine so much on if the skill shots are going to land. The empowered Q, if the first couple empowered Qs lands, then that gives you such an advantage in your lane, especially against something like Leona, where if they take a lot of harass early, then they lose all their threat.
Mm-hmm.
So that might be what's giving them pause.
It's going to be Elise picked up for the jungle anyway, so both E junglers. I'm going to get that one wrong maybe 5 times this game. I'm going to count. Shyvana top lane for Zeros. You're going to be safe. Jax, the counter pick here for Odwamna. And it is Sivir once again for C9E.
Oh, so Zoro does get one of his favorite champions, though. So that is a pretty big win for NIP. Going up against Jax, that will probably be tipped greatly by jungler influence, that matchup.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting to see here. They've got a Nidalee at mid, so if it is a lane swap...
Yeah, it'll be an advantage.
Oh, I haven't made the final switch yet. Could be a Nidalee support, Karma mid.
unlikely.
They switch it back.
Yeah, yeah. So you're right. So let's think about that sort of game plan then. If it's like a 2-on-1, right, you've got Ahri with the push lead against Nidalee, who it's a bit hard to last hit under turret with. I've seen people succeed with it, but it's difficult in general. Nuke Duck, I feel like has kill pressure over Forbidden as well, though.
Yeah, and then you got your Evelynn will probably be showing in lane with the 2v1 switch.
Yeah, true.
But again, they like their duo lane to have the 2v2 matchup, and they like extending laning phase. Zoro's also going teleport here, so
yeah,
probably be standard.
Double teleport top laner, Elise versus Eve in the jungle. Elise, it's interesting because they gank so differently. Basically, the reason Evelynn works is because she could just always be there and you can't ward for her, but the Elise gank itself is so powerful. You've got a second stunned, way more damage. You've got a move block. You can turret dive and drop aggro. I mean, so you've got so many cool potential, like so much cool potential there where like, it's also interesting because you've got a no CC top laner Shyvana with a stunning and slowing jungler with Elise. On the other side, you've got no CC jungler with Evelynn, but a Jax there to set up stuns. So I feel like the actual fight between the two lanes is kind of comparable with jungle interference.
Jungler and top laner stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be interesting. What I really like about Evelynn, though, is that since she can bypass all wards, she's good at counter jungling. If she can find Elise at a camp, already attacking a camp, then she has a great advantage. And you can get, you can relieve all this early game ganking pressure of Elise that way by finding her in the jungle. And Ko has been one to seek out other junglers in their jungle and set up wards. So we'll have to see who can get the early vision down.
Well, here we go into the matchup, guys. 2,400 gold on each team. Equal game. Tie score. Got a GP10 picked up for Voidal. No surprise for these guys. Mythia is one to sit at the tier 1 gold pretend the entire time. And just buy a slice from the rest of his items later on. See where these guys move. Cloud9 Eclipse. I've seen this before.
Yeah, so I would really expect them to make an early game move. Since for all the reasons that we went over in champion select, it looks like they're making a bottom though.
See what they can find. Ko's gonna make his way up first. He sees okay that Freeze is actually gonna watch for this one.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
So he's gonna be safe, and he's gonna see Freeze actually backs up a little bit here. He doesn't know that Evelynn is around, but you know he's gonna be okay anyway. So far, Cloud and Eclipse gonna make their way slowly towards the jungle. I think this is interesting because if you're not camping in brush, you could theoretically, although this team doesn't have it, like create an opening where like you could land a hook on someone because Eve sees them. But not the case in this game, for what it's worth. Ko gonna make his way back around towards the mid lane there. Cloud9 Eclipse just watch for the early, kind of just watching for the early invades, but not finding their own way in.
Yeah, they're not even actually setting up in the bushes here. Everybody grouped up though. They might be able to five-man defend this blue. Placing the ward here, looks like they might even have a trap laid for NIP. Oh, the mind games early here. Great early ward here. They're expecting the blue side invade. They actually want to catch NIP attacking their blue.
And the whole team is there. They come across the wall. They do get spotted. Javelin comes in as well. Good early burst to Miffy. Powered Q already burned as well. Some damage on a Horde Belter. He's forced to run away. Nice Javelin lands onto him as well. And Cloud9 comes with a big health lead on their team. And they grab the early buff. So teleport to the bottom lane for Zoro. He wants to go bot. It's going to be a 2v2 top lane.
Yeah, I like this play from Cloud9 Eclipse early. They expected the blue side invade. They countered it very well. Got a little bit of a lead, taking the jungler low on HP. It's going to cause Elise to use more of her health potions. However, she does not have a problem with health in the jungle. Having started machete and health potions, she can easily use her spiders to tank things. Chugging a few of those potions won't mean the end of her.
Just now, level 2 for Holberto finishes his first camp, whereas Ko on Evelynn already finished the wolves and has finished the red buff for himself. So a level lead for the jungler of Cloud9 Eclipse before 3 minutes is already around the map.
And he knows that Evelynn was weak, he knows that Elise was weak. Now he got Meme doing it. He knows that Elise was weak from the failed invade, so you want to go continue to fight your opponent who is at a disadvantage. Going into the jungle, waiting for her to start blue. Once he starts blue, then he'll engage here because he's taking a lot of damage from it. He's low on mana too. Great job from Ko. Continuing the pressure, he'll be able to easily steal away that blue as well. Might even get a kill.
Flash. Forced to flash the wall. 100 health left. Ko has Trinket Ward, pops it in the brush, starts up the blue buff. No one is around to stop him.
Man.
Three buffs start for C9.
Cloud9 are going to be sad when they don't get to use Ko. He's too young. Man, he's a really big part of their team, though. Again, yeah. Very good early start here from Cloud9 Eclipse. Complete control of the jungle. Mm-hmm. lot of poke landing early too. As I said, it's all focused onto one target. They were targeting Leona, take away all of her threat.
Yep. I mean, you've already got the recall as well. Like 22 to 13 in minions. Freeze now stuck, hiding underneath his turret. Cloud9 Eclipse going to freeze that for a while. And, of course, to finish your point, Ko's birthday, I believe, is in about September. So he'd be available for Worlds, but pretty much none of the summer split. If they make it into LCS, of course.
Doing the counter jungle.
Mm-hmm. Level 4 versus level 2. Vivian takes the last little camp right there, so no experience at all to Hubrout, though. He's got Boots of Speed and the Machete. That's all the jungle Elise has right now. And
yeah,
only a red buff. Not the fastest jungle clear.
At this point, you do not leave the enemy jungle. A level 2 Elise is not a threat to you. Your lanes are winning. They can collapse pretty well. I mean, well, Nidalee's not really winning. She's even. That's all that you need, though, because you have such a huge advantage over the other jungler. He can set up camp and continue to die all of the big minions. Make sure that this Elise stays underleveled, does not apply any pressure early, and yeah, it's a very, very big win for Cloud9 Eclipse, especially since they have the late-game Nidalee to rely on and the late-game Sivir.
Ko's going to make his win towards Nuke Duck. Level 5, and the Ahri's going to jump away. Foxfire burned right there. A bit of mana taken off, but not too much damage at the end of the day. Vivin, 35 to 39 in minions. Staying pretty close, 10%, not bad. Roberto finally level 3 to the almost 5 of Evelynn. More harass out of the turret, though, from C9E's duo lane here. Putting some good damage in.
Yeah, they've been able to shove with a clear conscience because they've had complete vision of the Elise. So being able to take advantage of all of their AoE damage, shoving waves in, get their advantage that way. It's like a pretty good foothold they have in the top lane.
Yeah. It puts Manifest is 500 gold in the scoreboard right here, but it feels like quite the start for these guys. 39 to 32 in minions for the two top laners as well, although they're, of course, at the bottom, but Odwamna is winning against Zoro Zero. And is that late game Jack? The all-in from Nuke Duck. Charm's going to get flashed by Febivin. Level 5 to 6. Nuke Duck tries the all-in. Only finds so much.
And you can see how quickly he backed off there. It's because he's playing against an Eve in the jungle. Mm-hmm. Like, he wasn't scared of this Nidalee who's low on mana pre-level 6.
Yeah.
There's no repercussions there. He needs to make his move and then get away just because there is an Evelynn on the enemy team. That's the kind of threat that I'm talking about. That's the kind of passive power that you gain when you run this champion in the jungle.
You're going to see the ping towards the top lane right here. Javelin's not going to land a Nuke Duck, but you can see the moves made here by Ko. He's actually going to find Hilberto. 5 versus 4. Oh, actually, they're going to cross paths right here.
Yeah, he's going to get a good chunk of HP that he's going to be able to take off. Lost track of him. There he is.
Ko has a lot of wards down. Spots Hilberto, half HP. Force run away. More damage coming through. Now there's no flash for Elise. But he's just forced out of the jungle. Ko, as you said, is living in there.
Yeah, not only does he have a huge experience advantage, but also Elise purchased that pink ward, 100 gold. Evelynn will find that pink ward very quickly as he's spending so much time in this red side jungle. And you can't defend that pink ward. Your mid laner is not in position to defend it, 2 versus 1. Your jungler is not even there. So if Ko walks through that bush, not only is Elise down a bunch of experience, but also a lot of money. She didn't have a lot of money to start out with. Also, there it goes.
Yep. Spots it.
That board. Precious 100 Gs down the drain. Oh, they didn't kill it.
Well, I think they're trying to get this red buff. They know the timer on it. Because remember that basically he got...
Well,
like, they know the
spend
red
a couple
timer.
Seconds and kill the pink ward.
Yeah, okay. Finally there they go for it. There we go. Vivin goes into Cougar form. Gets a bit more damage that way. Gets the reset on the Q. But Hilberto, mind games right here, goes for the other sided red buff there. And he actually might be able to secure a buff for himself 8 minutes in.
Yes, it's a good job making the best of a bad situation. You have to give up control of your side. He's making a risky move, but since there are no wards down that saw him enter, he's okay.
Yeah, I have to celebrate that. How smart that was, though. It's like, okay, the dual lane, right, it's on the other side of the map. I'm not going to get jumped by Jax. Even gets to rappel over the wall to Dragon. Doesn't get even spotted on his way out. I do have to celebrate that. It's a good play, but we'll see if C9E can control more buffs here. Ko is making his way towards the blue buff soon.
This turret, it will go down whenever Cloud9 want it to as well. They're in complete control of this game. They've got this 1,000 gold lead before the turret even goes down. So this is going to get even worse for them.
Ko, he's looking to dodge the charm and just keeps juking back and forth. Nuke Duck's not going to commit for this one. Ward over the wall, but they pulled it into the brush. Smart play by NIP. Actually, to Hulberto, a Spiderling stole it. Could have switched to human form.
Oops.
But good pull. They knew E was around, but it does still mean that blue buff is secured, even if mistakenly to the wrong champion. Club and Eclipse will be able to get blue buff onto their own needily before too long. There we go. Top turret is down. Ninjas in pajamas, though. Despite the very rough early jungle play, managed to go 2-for-2 on buffs in the second rotation. But Cloud and Eclipse are just winning all their lanes right now. Looks like 13 minions for Odwamna versus 0-0, and of course the turret will be in
carry.
Man,
that is brutal down there. Jax winning at this point is very, very bad for NIP. He's going to have a very strong late game, especially coupled with Ko. Let's see here. This would be it'd be hard to pull off a kill here, as Shyvana does have her ulti and flash. So yeah, not a lot of potential there for success if they go for a dive.
Okay. Looks like not the case then just yet for these guys, but it is maybe dragging the potential right here. 1,600 gold in the lead as Platinum Eclipse. They're going to make that close to 2,500 with this one. No one is even looking to stop them right here. Ko and Vivid just by themselves. They take that down rather quickly. Kill goes over to Ko, and you can see now 15k versus 12.8.
Man, look at the items for AD carries. BF Sword and Vamp Scepter. If they meet up before... Okay, mid lane there. Nuke Duck's in trouble.
Root's going to land Javelin as well. First Blood goes to Voidal. All of the skill shots hit right there. Cloud Man Eclipse, big lead.
Ah, oh, the Karma Tether.
Yeah.
That'll get you every time. All right, so they're actually able to kill Ahri despite ulti and flash. Odwamna here, though, in trouble.
Gets out to a Trinket Ward. Nice. I'm always curious if I should, like...
Whoa, he stayed around, and Zoro's going deep.
All right. So clear the wave, looks like it's going to be safe.
Yeah, just quick clear the wave. He's not worried about people collapsing on him either,
yeah.
Just because he saw everyone mid before. So that's why he was able to go aggressive here. One wave successfully denied from Jax.
Look at that mid lane kill again.
Here. 3-on-1, no fair. The slow from Ko was enough to keep her in range of the tether despite the flash.
Yeah. Nicely done right there, so that's going to manifest in a bit of a minion lead right there. Zoro did manage to equalize CS okay in that bottom lane. Is going towards the sun.
Oh, he got it. Wow. Yharnam taking away everything from Freeze.
And a 31 minion lead. Massive, massive lead in that top.
This is against the team that had a perfect game yesterday.
Yeah.
NIP had a perfect game yesterday, and Cloud9 are just obliterating them. With a great early game. This is a complete snowball off that early game.
And they've got late game insurance too. They got Sivir Jax, they've got Nidalee. Like, C9E looks so good right now. Wave clear by Nuke Duck. He's going for the early Deathfire Grasp. They've been chilling out. A couple of taunts, no big deal. Kills off the minions.
Yeah, at this point. So Nidalee starts off like a very weak mid lane. Not a lot she can do, not a lot of wave clear. Just trying to sustain there and CS. Once she gets post 6 and blue buff, she becomes a menace in the mid lane. It's so hard to shove her out. She can stay there forever. She can poke you down. She can gain control of a lot of objectives that are around mid lane because she can roam, heal your jungler, as well as land the long-range spears. So now he actually has a lot of presence in mid lane. Ko is feeling that much stronger about continuing his invade path. Because now he has a very prominent player who can assist him from the mid.
Yep. It's going to be all kinds of fun to watch the teamwork play out. Pebbevin, Nuke Duck still in battle, level 10 to 9. Good damage comes out, though, from Nuke Duck, honestly. Doing a good job trying to hold his opponent down.
Spam heals. He'll be fine.
Yeah, generally speaking. Blue buff did. I think it's going to time out very soon, though.
He just has to worry about the all-in. That's where you can grab Nidalee. But it's a flash barrier Nidalee. The highest
engage comes in, stuns onto Voidal. Culling, big damage comes in as well. The ignite on Voidal, but the team not able to keep following up on this one. Summoner heal was still available for Yharnam. Hulberto?
Yeah, we've seen a lot of AD carries. Okay, will he get out of this one?
Yep.
Doesn't even have to use spell shield. We've seen a lot of AD carries jumping on that heal bandwagon. Yeah, it's such a good summoner spell right now. Better than barrier, but down bottom we have some aggression. But a lot of the AD carries have not been using it to save their supports.
Yeah, I've noticed that.
They aren't used to it yet.
They're selfish players, as all AD carries are. I know from experience. Nuke Duck, though, takes a jab on the back of the head. Looks like the push is going to be good. Nice charm predicts the juke. Febivin gets him down to half HP, but Healy's going to probably kill these pretty quickly. Yep.
Yeah, I like how the mind games behind jukes change the higher you go. At one point, you just expect everyone to juke, and so then you start throwing your skill shots off on purpose.
And they walk into them, and you feel like a chump for walking into skill shots, but that's how it is. Ooh, Ko actually grabs the blue buff. Javelin's not going to help him with that one. Just wants to kill it quickly. All right, maybe he'll get his own, but Nuke Duck, though, pressing this mid lane very heavily. Febivin, you're seeing that time he didn't even shoot the skill shot. Juked himself. That one hit, though.
Evelyn is in the area, but he's actually doing Wraith, so he's not going to provide some backup here. He doesn't have his ulti, so kill potential not that high. Ari can easily ult away. Mm-hmm.
So, okay, it's going to be the minion kills once more in this one. Febivin going to clear Brother aggressively in this one, but looks like he's not going to miss much CS for it. And he's pushed Nuke Duck back. That is one thing I've noticed about mid lane Nidalee, is you have to kind of show no fear if you want to actually control your lane. Just go into Cougar form, clear things out, know if you're going to get killed for it or not. Rely on the heals if not.
Jax as well, showing no fear, going Blade of the Ruined King, first item, full offense here for him. Gonna be scary for Zoro. That's why he's continually pushed into his turret. There's just control all three lanes here for Cloud9 now. Yeah. Look, they have two pink wards in their own jungle for NIP. They're playing so defensively right now. They're trying to get control of their own jungle back, desperately buying some pink wards. Yeah. Those are good bushes to put them in, though.
Yeah.
That one at the top, by the top turret, almost nobody ever walks through that bush. If you're going to buy a defensive pink ward for your jungle, that's a great place to put it.
Yeah, they are very deep, though. I'm curious to see how much they're actually going to watch Ko. Because, like, right now, the general roam path, he's going to buy it. He's going to spot it.
So he went through also the little one in the river. That one spotted him this time around.
Ko just killed that ward, by the way. Ko does. He knows.
Finds the other pink ward inside red jungle. They are taking everything from NIP.
Even the pink wards aren't even surviving very long. Cloud9 Eclipse, one turret, one dragon, one champion kill. To zero across the board for NIP.
Jack's gonna go ahead and solo that dragon. Don't even need the smite there.
Wow. Karma Nidalee is a fun little combo. Because if you turn back, you'll take the second Q. And if you keep walking forward, it's like a really easy javelin. Nuke Duck, half HP.
Look at this team here. The Cloud9 Eclipse team can kill someone. Mm-hmm. If they hit all three of their skill shots, the Sivir plus the Nidalee plus Karma, that will kill someone.
Yes,
if those all hit at the same time. So this is a very heavy poke squad.
Yeah, Ninja's in fear right now. Mid lane outer turret about to be going down. It's going to be level 8 to 11 for both members of C9E. That's turret number 1. Turret number 2 under fire now. Going to be some quick wave clear. Hobotar at least has some wave clear, being Elise. Spiderlings help with that a little bit. Minions hit some traps. They've been bushwhacked. They're going to go down.
So jump tag him a little bit here. Full tank. Blade of the Ruined King's still active. Or the active is still available.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep that in mind.
I see some players actually spam that almost on cooldown.
Just for the regen.
To send a message.
Well, it's good DPS and it is good heal for you. So it's kind of like the Trundle idea, where if you're spamming your Trundle ulti on cooldown, and if the cooldown's pretty low, then you can out-sustain your lane opponent.
Mm-hmm. Avoida once again spots the pink ward. C9E.
He's got backup, too. This is pink ward bait at a next level here.
Ooh.
This is baiting the bait of the pink ward.
One more attack for Voidal. It does get away from the Mythi ultimate. Is that a Solar Flare down right now? And Cloud9 Eclipse look all
And they are going to collapse there on Elise.
Hobotar on the run. Stun's not going to land. Ko does get away with the W. Javelin nearly hits him in the face.
That was a good dodge.
Yeah. I think we made it a while ago, so that skill shots will show through Fog of War if they're close to you, regardless of it being untreated. So that helps him a bit with this one. Looks like top lane tier 2 turret does go down though, so C9E completely crushing from their duo lane. Now a 36 minion lead for the AD carry.
So the jungler having this much success is crucial for this Cloud9 team comp right here. They get ahead early with a Nidalee Karma Sivir tower poking squad. It's going to be pretty easy for them to end this one. I don't think we're going to see another 50-minute game here.
Yeah.
Cloud9 Eclipse have a very clear strategy to finish this. They have a great advantage when they have a blue buff on their Nidalee, and they can easily siege up at turrets.
Yeah.
It's the only thing they have to worry about is picks. Picks from the Ahri plus Elise combo, and then a flanking Zoro Zero. If they can avoid those, avoid that solar flare from Leona that's going to start it off, all they have to do is land maybe one round even of skill shots. And it will give them enough of an advantage that they could probably even survive an all-in team fight.
Well, Yurna's got to be a little bit careful. Nice javelin, though, pushes back Zoro Zero down to half HP for both these guys. And look at this. C9E in control now of NIP's blue buff. Looks like it will be the refresh here for Febiven. More javelins coming out. Athene's still the only completed item. He's got a lot of money.
Sivir ulti popped.
Well, can they find much? The slow comes in from Eve. The tether not going to land, though. Zoro Zero trying to run, but his flash is already down. Kill picked up. Yurna gets the kill credit for that one. They're going to back out.
I'm going with a split push Jax. He's actually going to stay mid. Four-man squad here should be able to handle themselves. Tank already down for NIP. The hard engage, very, very risky for them at this point.
Let's see what these guys can find with this one. The minion's all going to go down. Javelin helps with that one, but honestly, C9E not really pressing the advantage right there. Zoro Zero up in 10 seconds. They're not going to get much more. Odwamna.
Nidalee had a fresh blue buff, too. That's an interesting call right there.
But I think they had a lot of money in their pockets. I want to see what they buy. So there's a needlessly large rod, there's a Hex Drinker, and a Giant's Belt picked up. Finished Frost Queen's Claim as well for Voidal. So
those are pretty substantial increases in power.
Yeah. And a chalice and boots. So
Jax is doing a lot of counter jungling, actually. He's took dragon himself, taking red himself.
Yep. Well, it's a team effort here. Right? You said counter jungling is a team effort?
I did.
Jax can do it by himself. Doesn't need a jungler, Kobe.
All right. They do give up the mid turret for that. Everybody going back to buy.
Yeah,
they
true.
Spent,
no perfect
spent
game.
A lot of money there.
We'll see if they're going to capitalize off this one, though. It's going to be most of Trinity Force there for Odwamna, plus his two Doran's Blades. Ko does take his own red buff here with this one. So it's both red buffs now, plus, I guess, both blue buffs for C9E taken right here. So the entire jungle now belongs to the blue team. 21 and a half minutes in, 8,000 almost the gold lead. Spot Zoro Zero. He does have Dragon's Descent, but some good early damage. There's the tether as well. Exhaust on top of that one. Zoro Zero's rooted up, but he's waiting for his team. In comes Nuke Duck. They're going to dodge away from that one. Good ulti from Ko. And the dash away from Ahri.
They're able to get the flash away too. Karma survives, and now the re-engage.
Wow, and in they go. How much is this fight going to mean? It's going to be the nice ulti coming across. Voidal does go down. Caught too far into the front lines. 1-0 to NIP.
Dangerous re-engage here for the poke team. Trying to go in and capitalize on that one. A good little skirmish win for NIP, but it's still a blue buff Nidalee.
So we'll see what these guys can do with this one. Looks like right now Yurna just being the minion clearer for now. Phantom Dancer is done. That's going to be happy for that, man. Mid lane maybe still under fire. Of course, Voidal's back up. But will they do much with a 4v5? Looks like the team happy to retreat for now. Keep the pressure on. Dragon up in 10 seconds. It's going to be the rotation soon from the team. Voidal making his way over, so is Ko. C9E set up a bit of a trap with the Warden a bushwhack, but it's not going to mean too much. And now they get Dragon.
All right, so there was a little window here for NIP, though. Cloud9 could get sloppy in their rotations because a little jungle skirmish results in a kill for them. It was Voidal flashing out of the charm, but then re-engaging once Sivir comes back with the move speed, and they don't have a lot of hard engage there.
Oh wow, Nukedug just gets exploded right there, Odwamna, landing the CC, landing the kill.
It's a lot of times when we just flash over and somebody's dead.
Yep. Well, Spirit Rush just came up after death right there. Yarnin's still going to kill away some of these minions, but being safe, not taking any turret damage for it. Freeze trying to wave clear. Odwamna going to hold the top lane. See, he's getting massive. 211 minions right there. Would have Triforce going back to base. Ko taking a bit of pain right there.
Sloppy.
Trying to run away from this one. Gets blocked up again, but does get away from the Lightbringer. But no, down he goes. Mythi finds the kill credit. The fight still come in. NIP find two kills so far. They're still chasing down. 0-0 in the front lines. Voidal has very few places to go. In fact, he's just going to go down into the ground right there. Double kill for Freeze. Oh, Drummond not around to help.
Cloud9 getting really sloppy here. Actually, both teams come up with picks. Mm-hmm. Nuked Up goes down, and then Cloud9 don't feel like they're threatened at all. They themselves get into a bad situation. I was talking about how clear of a path it would be for them to end the game with all this poke. They actually overextend a lot here. Teleport in from Shyvana from behind, and they cut off Ko. He's going to try and get out, but they lock him up very, very well here, even with the shield pop from his Hex Drinker. Good job from NIP. Zoro teleporting in to cut off the team.
Yeah. He got so much time from the backline as well. Like, everyone, like even the Frost Queen's Claim Act was used to slow down Shyvana at the beginning of that fight. Was not available for the retreat, and you saw all the kills picked up. 0-0, despite having such a rough lane, having now a better impact on the game. 0-1-4.
The two-man Baron, they don't even have the Jax on it, though. Jax would be a crucial part in a quick Baron for this team, since he's got Blade and Trinity Force already completed.
Yeah. NIP instead, they're going to have to try to control the Baron area because C9E do have great ward control right now over it. Pink ward into the pink ward on the brush on the opposite side as well. You can see that might be the same game plan as before. Cloud9 and Eclipse still do hold on to 7,000 gold in the lead.
Well, if you're NIP, you're looking to land the exact same thing. Catch somebody out. Cocoon, Charm, or Solar Flare. They're looking to tag somebody. Zenith Blade misses over the Wraith camp.
So let's see, how much of it is split push, how much of it is dedicated siege, how much of it is all of the above. Febivin gonna join the rest of his group here. Vomna up in the top lane.
Yeah, it should be the Jax split push and then poking from this Cloud9 team. They're doing just that. They do have a little bit of side coverage here. Ooh, as far as wards go. Yeah, good rotation there just to finish off the turret. Now they want to ward up all the sides around the turrets that they're pushing because they're worried about the flank. As we said, Leona ulti, Shyvana coming in from the side, Ahri even, any of these things could be disastrous.
Let's see what they find with that one. No Boomerang Blade damage, but in comes Febivin again. Does have the new blue buff there stolen away from NIP's jungle. Once again, that's been controlled by Cloud9 Eclipse. In comes the Culling. Good damage to Febivin, but he can always heal himself back up. You see the health bar. Twice that should have been missing, but Primal Surge, and yeah. Now it's all back.
Looks like that last team fight sobered up Cloud9. They are returning to their game plan. We're going to have four-man poke squad here, split push with the Jax. We disengage with Karma if anybody gets close to us. Just continue to throw out as many spears and boomerang blades as we can to keep the enemy low.
This is such a good
It's actually just three-man poke squad if they do send it over, this time with Jax. That's a big difference.
And it makes so much sense, though. Odwamna's normally missing anyway. Oh, here comes the engage. Good spell shield by Yurna. Keeps himself pretty safe. It's going to be... Looks like the engage not going to happen. Of course, Evelynn normally invisible. Anyway, Yurna's going to ulti over to look for 0-0. Zoro's going to spot this out at the last possible second. Baron goes over to Cloud9 Eclipse, and the siege going to continue.
They're also going to get the turret and the flash here.
Wow. Charm, not going to mean too much. Nuke Dart takes a bit of pain, though, from Voidal as well. 0-0 on the retreat now. Mid lane, second tier turret's gone down. Mid inhibitor turret under fire as well. That will also fall in just a second. And there it is. Now the inhibitor laid bare. 27 and a half minutes. Cloud9 Eclipse controlling 99% of the game. Couple of missteps, but they're now looking for the bottom lane as well. The minion wave is already here for these guys. Once again, turret under fire. Culling coming across, getting rid of a lot of minions. But the poke coming through. Nuke Dart at half HP.
One more hit on the turret.
Down it goes. 8 turrets to 1 this game. C9E have given up 4 kills, but they've controlled the map basically the entire time.
Shyvana's trying to flank here. Might be a desperate engage from NIP.
Yeah, well, 13,000 gold lead is a pretty big deal. Ko gonna find 0-0 there in the back lines. Ulti comes across. Zoro forced to ulti away from this fight, so no engage there available. Bottom lane and hip now also gone. C9E. Will they close this game out right here with the lead they've got for themselves? Looking now for the top lane. A big wave's coming by for that one soon. Yurna's going to say, you know what? Screw the turret. I've got spell shield. Down goes that wave. Get some mana back. No spell shield available there for Yurna. Going to land the cocoon onto his head, though. This can be a great solo fight, but the flash keeps him alive. Odwamna in the front lines there. Fight engaged. 0-0 in the front lines. Looks like it's going to be C9E backing up. playing safe. Morpho coming through. Nice charm. Shield keeps him okay. But in comes Mythic into the front lines. Force a dash backwards. Udwamna does barely survive. Exhaust on the top side of the fight as well. Still tossing skill shots back and forth. No one going down. 0-0 going low.
All right. They're able to chase him off here, but two inhibitors down. Their base is in shambles right now. NIP are barely holding on at this point. It should just be the same standard plan from Cloud9. They got a little lackadaisical in the mid game. If they lapse again and they split up, they give over a couple more picks, they don't press their advantage, then NIP could climb back in. But if they just return to the top lane, it's pretty much all they have to do.
Yeah.
They could even actually just go for Nexus turrets.
Yeah, both would work honestly at this point. We'll see what CNNE does with this one. Don't think they're going to take too much more time with this one. Pepevin does make sure that they take the dragon down, though, so not leaving anything up in case something goes wrong. And if he has 1,000 less gold, they can grab for themselves. Dragon's going to be full value, 270, so fully late game dragon, 1,300 gold for that one.
Yeah, they're not messing around here. You're allowed to go back and purchase, and then you're returning to pressure. It looks like the call is here. Nidalee's going to grab his own blue buff, too. Stopping off at Wolves, he better just be barely hitting an item threshold. Otherwise, that is wasted time.
He's got 3,800 gold in inventory. Death Cap would cost 1,700, and Void Staff's 2,300. So if he hits 3K, then that actually is...
Oh, they go the engage! Cloud9 are split up. They have their Nidalee getting blue buff and farming Wolves and White.
Uh-oh, the stun on Udwamna as well. Can he get out of this one? Puts the dodge on, looks for some damage, but he's going down.
This happened at mid-game.
Yep.
They laxed in their play. They got caught out. They're giving the small... There's a trail of breadcrumbs here for NIP to follow.
And they're way back catching people out.
Yeah, they're way back into the game. It's through the jungle here, catching out people when Cloud9 are split up. Nidalee hasn't... Did she even go back to purchase? Yeah, she did get the combo. So she's got Death Cap Void Staff now. Even with losing two people, it's very, very hard to deal with.
And to be fair for Febivim, he's got like 60 gold in inventory. So the wolf camp was
so
worth
it. So he needed the wolf camp and the white camp. It was the team.
It was teamwork. It was a teamwork wolf.
He wanted the team
Death
to back
Void
off.
Staff was 4K.
But they got caught.
Yep. Okay. So... Red teams and hit there you go.
So,
Nuke Duck only level 14, not the highest he wants to be. Zoro 0, 16 in this one, chased down by Febivin and Co. Some good damage. Dragon's Ascent used Javelin in the back of the head, like 5 health left. Zoro 0.
Predicted juke to the right, almost cost him his life there.
Nice attempt on that one. So, see, if he had gotten the kill, that would have been because of Void Staff.
So, even with the extra items.
Oh, you're right. Sorry. He should have taken another camp out of Blue Elixir.
Yeah, there you go. He should have kept farming Jungle.
Should have ran an ability power seal.
All right.
More selfish. Mid lane and hip. Of course, these have respawned at this point. So, Clubman Eclipse going to re up their control over the base. Mid and hip is going to go down. Bottom and hip is soon. But they might just go down the mid right now. Big super minion down there. Minion wave is going to be falling rather quickly. There comes the respawn on this one. Minion wave not yet there in the top lane. Down goes almost the inhib, but C9E forced back. Ku going to get hit up by this one. Puts the ulti down. Can he stay alive? Looks like yes. Has a Randwood Zoman. Mithy now on the front line. Slowed down. Down he goes. Kill picked up an illusion. 3 kills so far for C9E. This could very much be the game. Stun on a Febivin might not mean too much. Javelin hits a Spiderling. Ko back in the lines. Febivin still in turret range. Got to back off. There you go. Keep himself up, but second Nexus turret now surely to fall.
Garden!
Cloud9 Eclipse.
Ooh, gets a heal.
They're gonna find themselves a 2-0. At this point, they're just kind of fighting for KDAs, but the game is surely to go to the blue team. 2-0, making it happen. Cloud9 Eclipse. They make it explode 32-48 into the game.
All right, so Cloud9 Eclipse with a dominating performance, really snowballing the early game well. However, there were some windows where they laxed.
Yeah.